This may sound off, but the Jurassic Park movies aren't as fictional as you might think they are. Some scientists are working hard to resurrect the species that are no longer with us. And they're getting a lot closer than you may think. These are extinct animals that scientists are going to revive. Number 15. Saber-toothed tiger. You may not be aware of this, but this is the first time in millions of years that our planet has been filled with saber cats. These terrifyingly powerful animals once ruled the Pleistocene era, and even managed to survive the last ice age. But they're now extinct. Well, until now. Technically, scientists aren't the ones who are going to bring back the saber-toothed tigers. Evolution is. Nobody really understands exactly why the saber-toothed tiger went extinct. But we do know that it wasn't all that long ago, 10,000 years to be exact. And since these animals were evolved from Nimerids, a kind of predatorial cousin of the modern-day cat, who's to say that our universe couldn't just develop a genetic sequel to these frightening animals? Anything is possible in the world of evolution, guys. It's only a matter of time before Dwayne Johnson becomes superhuman. The saber-toothed tiger, like all of us, is a product of evolution. But the conditions that led to the development of this unique animal are not all that far from our current reality. We may see another of these frightening predators very, very soon. Like this video, smash the subscribe button, and click the notification bell right now, or this centipede will crawl on your face when you're sleeping. Now it's time for the juicy topic. You lot out there exploring the internet, you love the Megalodon, don't you? Our videos about the infamous massive shark are among our most popular. While many of our vids have focused on the possibility that the creature may still be out there in some form, researcher Dr. Pimiento insists it's very much extinct, adding there's no way it can still be around. But some of his colleagues are looking to change that. Megalodon are one of the species on the top of the list for possible resurrection. Here's hoping that if they succeed, they keep the megalodons they revive away from me, because I do not want to be eaten by a massive shark. As always, comment down below with the hashtag #JuicyTopic and let us know your opinion in relation to what we just showed on screen. Let's move on to the next one. Number 14. The dodo bird. Sadly for them, the dodo bird is our modern-day go-to for an extinct animal. But the conditions that made it extinct are, tragically, the end product of other animals. It's kind of sad to think such an incredible animal died because of others. Thankfully, science is here to save the day. The dodo went extinct for a simple rule of nature. Everybody has to eat, even predators. While the dodos were simply trying to protect their eggs and raise their children, predators were enthusiastically eating a dodo egg breakfast, effectively bringing a swift end to the dodo legacy. But in 2016, a evolutionary biologist named Beth Shapiro announced an incredible advancement. They had managed to sequence the entire genome of the dodo bird, making the animal's de-extinction entirely possible. It was a heck of an announcement, one that could forever change the world of dodo lovers. Of course, bringing the animal back to life is kind of useless since predators will just continue eating its eggs, but let's not think about that right now. We have an animal that we can bring back from the dead. It's a scientific miracle. Number 13. Aurochs. Listen, I'm not gonna sit here and quote the Jeff Goldblum line from Jurassic Park again. We do that a lot around here, but when scientific experts are working to bring back animals from the 17th century, you really are tempting me. The auroch is the wild ancestor of what we know to be modern-day cattle, but they've been extinct since 1627. Cave art has shown us that these animals were well-known and admired by primitive humans centuries ago, though their discovery of agriculture and domestication is what led the animal to its eventual extinction. However, primitive man's description of the auroch has been nothing but positive, highlighting its incredible strength and speed. So it's no surprise that scientists have been trying to bring this animal back for decades. Two Nazi scientists in 1930s Germany came close, but failed to stick to the animal's anatomical detail, which, well, we should be happy about. Today, scientists are still seeking a way to faithfully recreate the genetic structure of the auroch, though nothing has been successful as of yet. Still, it's only a matter of time before you could see this wild cow ancestor roaming the earth. But again, just because you could, well, you know the line. Number 12. Ivory-billed woodpecker. I know. Why bring back a near-extinct woodpecker when we have Woody? I asked the same question. Apparently, people just really, really like this particular kind of woodpecker. Presumably because it doesn't have an annoying laugh, I don't know. The ivory-billed woodpecker is an animal native to the forests of the southeastern United States and Cuba. Thanks to habitat destruction and rampant hunting, this incredible animal has now been designated as definitely or probably extinct, an entirely avoidable fate. The last universally accepted sighting of this bird in America was in 1944, in Cuba, 1987. Since then, claims have continued to be prevalent, with evidence published in scientific journals, though none of these claims have been categorically confirmed to be true. However, rest assured, because scientists are on the case, working to locate, protect, and breed more of these animals to ensure the species doesn't die out. Can it be done? I don't know. I'm just a voiceover guy. The ivory-billed woodpecker is an animal that really doesn't deserve to go extinct because of human action. Thankfully, our scientists know and respect that. And I'm sure we'll hear that adorably annoying laugh once again. Wait. Oh, no. Woody's still with us. Why am I eulogizing him? Number 11. Siberian unicorn. Look, the kids have been asking for a unicorn for decades. It's time to give them what they want. Although the Siberian unicorn is, well, it's not like what we thought it would be. It's, well, it's Russian. And, it's not the graceful little horse we expected. Brace yourself. The Siberian unicorn is a kind of ancestor rhinoceros that, surprisingly, survived the last ice age and continued living until around 36,000 years ago. That's right, we were very close to living alongside big, burly unicorns. And when scientists finally began examining this unique animal's genetics, they discovered that this animal isn't even related to the modern rhino, but a different lineage that split away from what we would consider today's angry horned animal. But here's what you're all here for. The scientists discovered all of this by analyzing the animal's DNA. And you know what that means? Cloning. While they haven't shown much of a desire to do so just yet, it's only a matter of time before scientists decide to either revive or re-engineer the Siberian unicorn. I mean, it's a surefire way to generate some income for your lab, right? Number 10. Tasmanian tiger. In the 1980s, the Tasmanian tiger tragically went extinct. But of course, you should never underestimate science. They find a way, and in the case of the Tasmanian tiger, that is exceptionally true. We may be looking at an incredible case of de-extinction, folks. Thanks to a baby Tasmanian tiger collected over 100 years ago, science has enough genetic material at its hands to sequence the tiger's entire genome. That means they have more than enough to form a basic blueprint of this incredible animal, and even more intriguing, to recreate it. Scientists believe that this research is the first step on a long road to de-extinction, bringing the animal back, and helping it to thrive in the modern world. Can it be done? I'll leave that one to the experts. But it's looking pretty promising in the case of the Tasmanian tiger. The cause for this animal's extinction seems to be related to climate change, which negatively affected the vegetation around the Tasmanian tiger's environment. But I'm sure the scientists will find a way to handle this particular issue, maybe. Actually, if they could reverse climate change, perhaps they should focus on that. Welcome to my dream world, population 1. Number 9. Carolina parakeet. Once upon a time, in the forests of New York, A brightly colored wild parrot lived freely. That parrot was the Carolina parakeet, and it was eventually going to be extinct. Yeah, it's a depressing story. I never said it would be a fairy tale. The Carolina parakeet was a bright colored bird that was native to the United States. These animals could be found far and wide, from Florida to New York and even Colorado. Unfortunately, the last known Carolina parakeet died in 1918, leaving the species extinct for around a century. Something scientists claim is directly related to humans. Until now. Well, actually, no, it's still humans' fault. But just stick with me. Against all the odds, scientists successfully managed to sequence the parakeet's genome, giving them all the material they would need to potentially revive this extinct animal. Soon it could be back squawking away in those picturesque Florida swamps. Of course, bringing such a beautiful animal back doesn't mean that humans will stop needlessly exterminating them, but I guess it's a start. These are beautiful animals after all. We should at least have the opportunity to appreciate them, right? Number 8. Irish Elk. If you're a poetry buff, you're likely familiar with the Irish Elk, thanks to Seamus Heaney's poem, Bogland. If you're not a poetry buff, you probably don't know what the heck I'm talking about. And you know what? Welcome to my world. The Irish Elk lived during the Pleistocene era and made its home in the icy north of the planet. And you know what that means? Cryogenic freezing. Okay, not quite, but close. When animals die in these cold, cold parts of the earth, their bodies tend to be frozen and encased in permafrost. When that melts, the animals are almost perfectly preserved, making them perfect candidates for scientific research and, yes, cloning. Thanks to the sheer amount of fossils available for the Irish elk, it's no surprise that science is so ready and willing to clone it. After all, they're pretty beautiful animals. Who wouldn't want one of these things wandering around? Thanks to the natural world, the Irish elk is one of the most likely candidates for cloning. You may be seeing one of these animals yourself pretty soon. Who's to say? Number 7. Mammoth. Listen, I don't know who your favorite Ice Age character was, but I was always a huge Manny fan. And now they're finally bringing him back to reality. Yeah, Ice Age is now a real-life thing. Kinda. Stick with me on this one. Ever since the idea of biologically reviving animals started gaining traction, scientists have been particularly enthusiastic about the idea of bringing back the woolly mammoth. Perhaps they too are fans of the Ice Age movies, or more likely, they're hoping to use the mammoth's genome to help Asian elephants survive in the cold climate of the Arctic, thereby helping them cope with the effects of climate change. See? Not everything is about the Ice Age movies, guys. The process is expected to take many years, but scientists are optimistic that this cloning process will eventually help protect and conserve Asian elephants in the world. And that's a pretty good reason to clone, right? Now, full disclaimer, I have not spoken with, consulted, or even contacted Ray Romano for a comment, but I'm pretty confident in saying that he would be on board for a live-action Ice Age. I imagine his only request is that he doesn't get killed by the mammoth, which I think is fair. Number 6. The Baiji River Dolphin. It's not easy to get the title of Goddess of the Yanks, and I should know because I've tried multiple times, but the Baiji River Dolphin once held that title until it was cruelly dethroned and killed by humankind. Tale as old as time. So scientists are here to clone and revive it. Again, a tale as old as time. Between the late 1980s and the mid-1990s, the population of Baiji dolphins had dramatically decreased by over 75%. A 1997 investigation found that while there were once over 400 dolphins in the river, there were now just 13. Because of human activities on the river, including construction, overfishing, and an increase in boat traffic, these blind dolphins found themselves struggling to survive until they just couldn't anymore. but thankfully technology is here to save these magnificent animals. Scientists hoped that the Baiji dolphin would be one of a handful of animals suitable for the de-extinction process. But once again, there's a problem. You can bring these beautiful animals back to life, but what do you do about the humans polluting the waters? That's a question for, I don't know, doctors? Therapists? Who knows? Number 5. Woolly rhinoceros. Scientists aren't just eager to bring back the woolly mammoth, of course. They're also incredibly excited to potentially revive a 10,000-year-old woolly rhino. Because, you know, 10,000 is the new 18, guys. With the genetic cloning program. While remnants of woolly mammoths have been found worldwide, woolly rhino remains are very rare, and even experts are kinda clueless about them. We don't know exactly where they fit on the evolutionary timeline or how they lived, but we do know what they looked like thanks to the mummified remains of a 10,000-year-old rhino. Sasha, as she's known, was discovered and reconstructed in 2015, but scientists are considering taking things a step further. Their plan is to locate preserved fossils in order to genetically recreate and eventually clone the animal. Because, again, nothing is safer than having prehistoric animals walking the Earth again. It's worth highlighting again that not much is known about the woolly rhino. Even experts consider it to be one of the most mysterious animals in our planet's history. But science has decided that such a curious animal deserves a chance to walk again, if only for the benefit of getting answers. Sasha lives. Well, not yet, but soon, probably. Number 4. Passenger pigeon. You're probably sitting there thinking, why the heck are they reviving a pigeon? We have thousands! And you know what? You're totally right. But these aren't just your typical run-of-the-mill pigeons. These are passenger pigeons. And just to clarify, no, you can't ride them. Long ago, passenger pigeons were a huge part of the North American forest ecosystem. But sadly, they all went the same way as many, many other animals. Extinction. Today's scientists don't give up, of course, and have now concluded that there may be a way to bring these pigeons back within a matter of years. How, you ask? Well, obviously it's science. Thanks to advanced genetic research, biologists can now re-engineer the DNA of living band-tailed pigeons to match that of the passenger pigeon, thereby reviving the long-extinct species for a new generation. Scientists hope that this ingenious solution will result in a bird that looks and behaves just as it once did. Pretty smart, right? Of course, some scientists aren't happy with this blatant effort to play with the fundamental laws of nature, but then what does scientists know? We didn't get 5 Jurassic Park movies for nothing. Number 3. The ground sloth. Sure, we already have more than enough sloths with us, but this is an extinct one. Don't you want an extinct one too? The ground sloth is a diverse group comprising of all extinct sloths. Yeah, all of them. It turns out there were, well, a lot. The most recent surviving ground sloths managed to live until around 1550 BC, but there are many ground sloths alive between 2819 and 2660 BC. So far, at least give genera of ground sloth have been identified in North American fossils, but there are almost definitely many more yet to be seen. While there obviously aren't any recently deceased or preserved corpses for scientists to revive, there's a whole lot of fossils left over for them to research. And eventually, all of that research will likely result in the reanimation of these long-dead animals. And that's pretty cool. Unless it isn't. But I'm choosing to be positive. The return of the ground sloth could be a very impressive achievement for scientists everywhere. Still, it's highly unlikely until a more recently deceased sloth turns up or technology advances. And since these things have been dead for thousands of years, I wouldn't hold my breath. Because, well, you'll be extinct too. Number 2. Quagga. No, that's not a made-up word. Well, all words are made up, but this one is a genuine animal. Sequega is a zebra with less striping and a more uniform brownish color, and many people want to see it again. The Sequega Project is a scientific attempt to use selective breeding to create an all-new lineage of Burchell's zebra, which resembles the long-extinct quagga. Yeah, a lot is going on here. All the way back in 1955, Lutzek suggested that, through careful selective breeding, the plain zebra could eventually produce an animal that looks incredibly like the quagga. Efforts began in the 1970s to do just that, although nothing really happened until the mid-1980s when DNA examinations proved that it was actually possible. By 1987, zebras were captured and the rebreeding program officially began. And it actually kinda worked. While some of the zebras failed to develop the quagga-like qualities the scientists wanted, many of them did. And while this isn't quite reviving the animals, it's still pretty close. I mean, could you tell the difference between a quagga and an artificial quagga? I didn't think so. Number 1. The Moa. Flightless birds are fascinating, right? I mean, you have a winged animal that, biologically, cannot use its wings for their purpose. The bush moa is a flightless bird native to New Zealand, but it went extinct in the late 13th century, after Polynesians settled there. But all of that is soon to change. Through a pretty impressive show of technological advancement, scientists managed to reconstruct the moa's DNA from the toe bone of a museum fossil. That DNA reconstruction gives the scientists pretty much everything they need to revive this long-extinct animal. All they need to do is inject it into the egg of a living species, and voila, you've just reenacted Jurassic Park. But you know, hopefully without all the murder and global destruction. Although, how much harm can a flightless bird do, right? I've seen Happy Feet. They'll just dance a little. The moa is another step on the incredible road toward de-extinction. Thanks to technology, it's looking more likely than ever that we will eventually see a world filled with the kind of animals that have long been wiped off the planet. Whether or not that's a good thing, I'll let you decide. Which of these animals would you most like to see in the wild? Or do you think de-extinction is a bad idea? Let us know in the comments. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time!